Hello, and welcome to another Design Tips video. Today, we're going to show you one of the many ways you can design an Etsy cover in Vectornator. We'll be using the following skills to create it: gradients, rotating and duplicating objects, the color picker, and the text tool. If you haven't learned those or you need a refresher, be sure to check out our other videos. Let's open Vectornator and get started. Create a new document by tapping the plus button, and then select custom size, since Etsy covers have very specific dimensions. First, let me make sure we select pixels, and then I'm going to manually type in the width, which is 3360 by 840 pixels. Now click create, and a brand new canvas will appear. This is where the fun starts. Okay, straight off the bat, I'm going to draw a rectangle that is the size of my canvas in order to set up my background layer. To make it pop, I'll create a gradient and then play around with some colors. Now that I'm happy with the color, I will also change the direction of the gradient by grabbing and moving these two orange handles. Looking good, but it's definitely missing some graphics. So I'm going to add some images from my library, like these two right here. And now I'm just moving them around the canvas and changing their size so they fit the design better. Remember to hold your finger on the canvas while scaling your object to keep the ratio. To keep everything neat and tidy, I'm naming this layer Background, and then I'm going to lock it. Let's create a new layer for more elements. We are not done quite yet. In this layer, I'll import a few more graphics. I already made a few mock-ups of some iPhone cases using this beautiful illustration made in Vectornator by Sarah Alice Rabbit. That's the main product of our fictional Etsy store for today. And I think they actually turned out pretty good. Maybe we should make some new company swag soon. Okay. Now, I'm noticing that the background is a bit too dark for the images that I placed on top. So I'll go back to the background layer, which I am going to unlock. A nice way to visualize your layers is by turning on the Isolate Active Layer feature from the quick settings. And now, when I go to this layer, we only see the images. And when we select the background layer, we just see the background elements. To make the background lighter, I make sure that the current color is selected, and then I go to the color picker here and check a few options to see what works. Remember, designing is a process. To make it even lighter, I'll switch my view, select RGB, and adjust the transparency by changing the alpha channel. Now I'll lock it again and go back to our second layer. Let's see how we can play around with these elements. I am going to rotate this image 45 degrees, and then I will duplicate it a few times. By holding my finger on the canvas while duplicating, the graphics will automatically snap to the smart guides, and as a result, they will automatically align to the horizontal axis. Next up, let's make room for some text. We need to add the name of our store or product, right? I'm going to activate the smart guides as this will come in handy from this point on, and play around. Let's view the entire design again. I'm just editing the elements and moving them around for a bit to create a better composition. For the text, I'm going to create a new layer, which I'm going to call title. Let's name this layer too. I'll name it mockup. Please don't judge my handwriting. Okay. In the newly created tile layer, I will add a text box and then select the text color. I'm thinking that white will work well. Alpha to 100%. And then I'll choose our font from this dropdown list. I think I'll choose the usual San Francisco, which is a favorite in our team. I'll size it to 100 points, align it to the center, and then I will just name our store Vectornator iPhone Cover. The AI did a good job at recognizing my handwriting, but the text is not aligned well, as you guys can see. So I'll just use our trusty keyboard for that. Let's capitalize this word and also make it plural this time. I'll play around with the size, which I can do super easily by dragging my pencil once I've selected the font size button in the quick actions menu. But now I also want to change the color. Maybe I'll use this burnt orange that I can easily apply with the color eyedropper tool. Okay, finally, I'm locking the two layers and going back to my background so I can change this image in the corner here. Maybe if I adjust the size, it will look better. Or if I move it around. Okay, not a big fan of these colors, so I will just hide this image. And then I think I will duplicate this other graphic. Then I'll play around with it until I'm happy with the result. I think we're done. Let's export. Select JPEG or PNG. If I select PNG, transparent background is an option, but it's not really relevant to our project. I prefer to go for the JPEG format, quality set to 1. The final step is to click export and save it to your desired location. And here is our brand new Etsy cover. Hope this video helped you guys. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more tutorials and design tips. Till next time.